As graceful as ever, she sits at a pier in Long Beach, south of Los Angeles, looking every bit as if she's about to head off on another spectacular cruise. But in fact, the Queen Mary hasn't gone anywhere for over 51 years. And those years have taken a toll, so now the old girl is getting a makeover, $50 million worth.
It was important to us to fix the ship. The Queen Mary is an icon in Long Beach and Southern California and really all over the world. And we owed it to the world to make it new again.
The Queen Mary set off on her maiden voyage from Scotland in 1936. In her time, the most luxurious ship afloat and a real magnet for the rich and famous.
Clark Gable, Vivian Leigh, Mae West, Greta Garbo, they all sailed.
Once she was moored permanently here in California, she became a favorite for conventions and still to this day operates as a hotel. But the new owners took over a ship that, beneath the many coats of paint, could well have been headed for the scrapyard.
When they would do renovations, they take out steel and concrete, they would literally just throw it in the bottom of the ship and it just rusted into this big, massive junkyard.
Eventually, they cleaned all that out. And to keep the ship and the business afloat, they needed more. So there are big plans now for the adjoining land.
And we're putting in 500,000 square feet of retail and entertainment. A lot of dynamic, energetic activities. We're going to be having live music. We'll have active boardwalks, street performers. We're going to have a 4,000-seat amphitheater.
A night on board the Queen Mary is a reminder of the good old days.
She generally carried 2,000 passengers and 1,200 crew members per crossing. 56 different types of wood veneer used in the interior decoration of the ship. We are told today that 6 of the woods used aboard this ship are extinct.
During the Second World War, the Queen Mary became a prime target for the German Navy, and Adolf Hitler even offered a huge reward to any submarine captain who could sink her. So for a while, she sought shelter in the waters around Australia. But when things worsened, she rejoined the war effort and carried thousands of Aussie troops to Europe.
So she went down to Sydney and she was transporting Australian and New Zealand troops. She was there from March of 1940 until December of 41 when Pearl Harbor came about.
While the development adjoining the ship is designed to capture a new audience, on the Grand Old Lady of the Sea, it's the opposite, making sure that once you step on board, it's a trip back in time. In Long Beach, California, Robert Penfold, Nine News.